Every man's life ends the same way. It's only the details of how he lives and how he died that distinguish one man from another. Ernest Hemingway. I'm on an alien planet, alone. I have no idea how I even let myself get to this place, let alone do I have any idea how I let it get this far out of control. I never thought it would make me question myself and question who I am as a person. This unfamiliar place, a state of purgatory. I can hear them talking to me. But no matter how much I explain myself, they can't hear me. It's a vicious cycle. Every morning I wake up and I get to do exactly what I love to do for a living. I get to race my dirt bike. I race on one of the best teams in my discipline and I've won championships. But why am I feeling like this? Honestly, think I'm lying to myself right now. I know why. I mean, let's call it what it is. I feel empty. The thing I love the most has sunk me in a dark hole and I can't bear to see the light. At times, you find yourself searching. You take a look at things, and you set aside what you do for a living. And for me, it just didn't sit right. I'd hop in the van, I'd hang a left, and I'd feel better already. Because I knew for that moment, all things would be okay. I don't know where I'm going. I don't know when I'll come back. I don't even know if I will come back. Nobody knows where I'm at. Hell, I don't even know where I'm at. But maybe that's okay. Maybe this is what I needed. If I feel like I need to be alone, then why do I feel like I need something? I need somebody, anybody to tell me I'm not crazy. But they're not. Nobody's here. Why do I feel this way? Does anybody feel this way? Am I crazy? So many questions. Unanswered. I think it's okay to walk through the valley of death. Maybe not alone, but maybe that's what I needed, because in the grand scheme of things, we're only here for a fraction of a moment. So why not be honest with ourselves and admit we all hurt sometimes, or that we all have fears, right? My biggest fear isn't that I won't live up to my own expectations, but it's being just like everybody else. It's being just another face in the crowd. I don't want to be one of many. I want to be one of one. Yet, you're either mocked for being authentic to oneself or idolized for conforming and being just like everyone else. For me, I found comfort in being uncommon amongst the uncommon. I hope we can realize that we have an imagined sense of self-importance, a delusion of privilege amongst a vast universe that cares nothing about us. Because at the end of the day, there are no runners.